When you're manufacturing or adding machining to parts in Toolbox, there's a lot of talk about phase 5 and phase 6 operations. In this next video, I want to go through the process of adding just some very simple holes on both phase 5 and phase 6 and show you the difference between the two. So let's go ahead and open up a project and get started. And we have this one door base cabinet that we'll work on. To start off, let's go to part properties and we're just going to add a simple machine token. In the open space, just right click, this menu appears, and we're going to add a new token. This will just be a drilling operation. And by default, you see on the bottom that we have a bore 5. Now that's representing a phase 5 machining operation. Now how do we know which one we need? Is it 5 or 6? To determine whether or not your holes or machining need to be on phase 5 or phase 6 of this part, come into the origin and rotation tab and check out where that machine point is. So this is a machine point 2M, just meaning that it's a mirrored part. We don't have to worry about that right now. We'll save that for another video when we talk about how parts are being nested on your sheets for production. So machine point 2M, here's the front edge of the base bottom. And this would be as if we're looking inside of the cabinet. So the way that these parts are being displayed here are just as if they were drawn inside of your product. So the base bottom laying flat like this inside of the product. And this is phase 5 being the inside of the cabinet. Phase 6 is just on the opposite face. So if we were to change this machine point from a 2M to just a 1, then the phase 5 machining would then be on this side here. And that would be on the bottom of the cabinet. Now, we don't recommend changing the machine points on any of these parts inside of the microvellum products. That's more so for when you're creating your own custom products and defining your own base points and machine points. Now, just to take a look at another part inside of this list, here's our base left side, front edge. Again, looking at it as if it were part of the product. Machine point on this corner, which means the inside is phase 5. There's our right side, there's our machine point, meaning this is phase 5. Here's our base front stretcher. Now, phase 5 and phase 6 are both inside of the cabinet, right? So it's not always the case where phase 5 is inside the cabinet and phase 6 is outside. That just doesn't always apply. So machine point is determining that phase 5 or phase 6. There's phase 5 and there's phase 6. Now that we've confirmed that it is going to be a phase 5 operation, we'll go into the parameters and start making the changes to locate this first hole. So we'll leave X, Y, and Z alone. This will just be very simple. That way we can see it coming in off the corner of our part. The X and the Y location is also based off of the machine point. So it'll be 1 inch away from that corner in both X and in Y. Z will be the depth of that hole, which is 1/4 inch or 7 millimeters. And without doing anything else, save, close, and redraw, and we'll see that hole appear on this part. There it is. There's our 5 millimeter hole. And now into 2D part editor, you see that hole is green representing phase 5 again. Green machining always being on phase 5, red being phase 6. Pull a quick dimension, there's 1 inch in X and 1 inch in Y. Now I'm going to repeat the process. Go back into that same part through part properties. And instead of adding a new token, I'm just going to simply copy this one. Same, right click in that open space, copy. Now we have a bore 5, but because I want to have this on the bottom of this part, I'm going to go into this text box and just change that 5 to a 6. Make sure that we always hit apply formula after we're making a change in the text box. And my parameters, we'll also just update those. We have a slightly different location. Redraw. Isolate that part. There it is. You can see we have our two holes. One is on phase 5 and one on phase 6. Now into our 2D part editor. There's that red machining hole, phase 6, and 2 inches away from our machine point. So that's a very simple way to add phase 5 and phase 6 machining onto one part. Now, of course, as this gets processed for production, we'll have to do a little bit of extra work now because we have these two holes on different faces. We'll have to do the process of phase 5 with cutting them out and then come back and handle our phase 6, or however you handle phase 6 machining. Because, of course, we do have that phase 6 first option. And for more information on that, check out some of our other videos that deal with manufacturing and processing stations. And that'll wrap up another training lesson in Microvellum Toolbox. Thanks again for joining me, and I'll see you on the next one.